smooth, or be something that's easy as taking a breath that can help you mitigate that stress. So that's why I wanted to ask Sequel Rob, because she sees the effects of not being able to deal with stress effectively, right, in his practice. And then, also he wrote a book on Tai Chi, so.
I actually talk about this inside the book, too. We have, of course, what we call the Wu Qi stance. We start from here. For the Yang style, their Wu Qi stance actually starts from here. This is their relaxed stance. And this is actually where they start their meditation from. From before, in the beginning of class, Sifu Li, we all sat cross-legged, we had our hands over our dantian. What they do to start is they start at nothing, because that's always the best place to start. If there's always something that's bothering you, want to get it away, get rid of it, start from nothing, start from empty. And for them, this is empty. And all it is just the feet shoulder length apart, hands at your side, and you can just close your eyes here and just breathe in, breathe out. And each time you breathe in and breathe out, feel your body relax. Breathe in, breathe out, you relax. Breathe in, breathe out, relax even more. As you do this, you'll start to feel your body sink into the ground. I know that's kind of a strange thing. It's more of that you can feel a distension or a pulling down feeling instead. Why this is occurring is because your muscles are relaxing. What's happening is you're not keeping your body and all your weight up on top. Now it's starting to flow down instead. This is a type of sinking method, and it's actually a good method to use if you're trying to train your stance as well. Just nice and easy. In. And you can do this for about a minute. The real trick here is to breathe from the dantian, breathe doing abdominal breathing. There's a reason for this. Sifu Li will demonstrate with me. Did you feel any of this tension feeling? Did you feel any of the moving down feeling? Now, this is why. Yeah, you can do this anyway. Yeah, and actually, one of the ways that people talk about doing this is doing it in like the conference room while you're sitting down. Do it somewhere where you know you're going to be stressed. You can start doing this abdominal breathing. You can even keep the eyes open so it doesn't look like you're falling asleep.
Yeah, getting fired for sleeping on the job probably wouldn't be stressing.
That's not good for me to shut my eyes.
Yeah. But this is kind of the reason why we do the abdominal breathing. Because if you do the breathing from the upper chest, you're moving all your weight up to here as well. And that's not actually good, especially while you're doing Tai Chi. I saw some of you, while you were doing the legs, pulling it over and bringing it up, some of them were kind of teetering. And the reason being is you got too much weight up on top. And this will show you why. So I'm just going to go into a bow stance. What I'm going to do is I'm going to breathe with my upper chest. And then Sifu Li is just going to put his hand here and just push lightly. Go ahead. And you can see I can just kind of fall over. And the reason being is because I've actually changed my center of gravity from here to up here. And when you're stressed, that's the first thing you do is you push everything up into your chest. So instead, you use the abdominals. You're trying to bring everything down instead. So he's going to do the same thing. I breathe in from the abdominal. And you can see that it extended. So now he's going to put his hand in the same place and push. Oh, loose. Okay. But this is the big difference between the change and the center of gravity. Instead of having him, you know, push me where my center of gravity is up and I just fall over, instead he's pushing me down this way. And the stance, you saw that was in the most stance. What happens is as you push, that force itself comes down, goes through the leg, out the foot, and down to here. One of the things they talk about in Tai Chi is this redistribution, this redirection of force. And what Tai Chi teaches you is you don't have to do that with force, you can redirect stress as well. This way it doesn't affect you. You learn to adapt, you learn to flow with it, instead of letting it hit you full force in the chest. Oh, I can't do this anymore. The second exercise, which is also very easy, starts from the Wu Qi, and now we're going to do the Tai Chi stance. So from the feet, you know, feet, shoulder length apart, hands at your side, we imagine that there's a ball in the middle of the body. And the idea here, as you breathe in, you bring the hands up, the fingertips are going to go along the outside of the ball, across the top, and down the back. And we do this in the form. But the idea is simple. You just repeat this. Bring the hands up, breathe in, you get to the apex, you come down, breathe out. Now there's a trick to this. What you want to imagine is that there's a string, or you have your back against a pole. You have a string at the top of your head, and it's pulling this part up, and there's a string underneath that's pulling it down. So the whole back becomes straight. You're just moving it and holding it there while you move across the ball. And then we take it a step farther where you rise and sink with it. So as you come up, your legs come up, hands come up, go across the top of the ball, hands come down, the legs go down.
Expert level on that this is keeping that abdominal breathing. So
yes.
Sometimes when you breathe in and you're coming up, you tend to feel lighter,
yeah.
Right? But try to breathe into the stomach as you're coming up. So
this,
that you still, even as you're pushing yourself up, you still feel that sinking feeling.
Yeah.
You still feel like you're being pulled into the ground. And then just as you breathe out, it's easy to sink, right? It's easy to and kind of relax, but it's when you're breathing in.
And this is one other thing. Oh, sorry.
Sorry.
This is why they like to do Tai Chi with senior citizens, because by doing this, by keeping the stability while breathing through the abdominal, it helps them keep their balance more. They won't fall over as much. That's very important. My grandmother, who was 83 at the time when I got married, she fell over and just broke her hip. And I mean, it's rough sometimes, but a lot of them find that they're more stable